Welcome back. I'm David Guerra. Just over 2 weeks away from the midterms, there's a lot of attention trained on the gubernatorial race in the state of Georgia between Democrat Stacey Abrams and Republican Brian Kemp, who I should say is also Georgia's Secretary of State. Earlier this week, there was outrage as local officials stopped a bus filled with some 40 black senior citizens who were on their way to vote. Joining me now is Katie Phang. She's an MSNBC legal analyst, and LaTosha Brown, who co-founded the group Black Voters Matter, which organized that bus trip to the polls. Let me ask you first, LaTosha, if I could, just for your reaction, when that happened, when you heard that that bus was stopped.
We were just amazed. We couldn't believe it, that we had had an amazing time earlier where the seniors, we had a presentation, they went out to the bus, they wanted to actually go to vote, they had requested to go vote, and we got on the bus and we were chanting, and just as we were pulling off, the bus was stopped. And then we found out why. We were just absolutely, we couldn't believe it. It was almost unbelievable in many ways, and we felt like a series of emotions. We felt, a part of me felt sad, a part of me even felt angry, a part of me felt, I was extremely disappointed because the seniors was disappointed, but it was very shocking.
And they did make their way to vote eventually, I gather. What did they say to you about the experience afterward, about this having happened to them?
You know, what's really interesting is, I think, their resilience and how strong they are, that even on when the bus was stopped, immediately one of them said out loud, they were like, they want us to get off the bus, right? So they weren't really shocked, because these are people, let's think about it, these are people 70 and 80, and they've seen the spectrum of voter suppression. They've seen the tactics before. They've experienced a lot. And so as they were getting off the bus, many of them said, don't worry about it, baby, we're going to vote. We're going to vote. And then so we went down, we actually went back to, we drove 3 hours when we went back to Jefferson County on Wednesday. And when we were there on Wednesday, one of the women who was on the bus, she said, I got straight off the bus and I went and got in my truck and I went and took a friend to vote. And then there were others that said that they voted. So what it really did is it really strengthened their resolve, that they were determined that they were going to vote. So since that time, almost all of them have actually gone to vote. And it actually, they didn't just go by themselves. Many of them took a family member or went with a family member.
Katie, I want to turn to you and ask you about this issue more broadly. There was a piece by Jelani Kopp in The New Yorker looking at voter suppression. He cited some data from the Brennan Center at New York University Law School. There have been 99 bills, he wrote, designed to diminish voter access introduced last year in 31 state legislatures. Help us understand the magnitude of what we're seeing.
So, David, as a trial lawyer, I'm driven by numbers and by evidence, and the numbers do not lie. Under Brian Kemp's tenure in Georgia, you've seen 214 voting precincts closed. You've had 1.5 million voters purged from voter rolls. And right now, with 53,000 voter registrations on hold, and that is the subject of litigation that's been brought as recently as October 11th, 70% of those 53,000 registered voters are African American. So, David, when you talk about voter suppression, it is so insidious and it's not totally in your face. You don't have an issue where a voter shows up at a poll and they're told, stop, you can't vote because you are African American, Asian American, Hispanic. That doesn't happen. And because it is so insidious, you have to look at the laws themselves. And it's a little bit of an ugly chicken and the egg cycle, because you need to get to the polls to vote to change the composition of your legislature. I mean, think about the fact that in the Trump administration, you have 84 new federal judges. Those are the judges that are going to determine whether or not an injunction is put into place to protect voters to be able to go to the voting booths. And because of that, it's very important to ensure that there's access to the courts to have this type of litigation heard, so that at the end of the day, you actually have the ability to get to that voting booth.
LaTosha, you know, well, this has a long historical legacy. I want to ask you, what's different this time around? We look at those early voting numbers, the quantity of people in Georgia who are coming out to vote in this election. One wonders about the system's ability to handle all of that. What's different in 2018?
You know, I think that people are really tired. Mm-hmm. Folks by goodwill are actually resisting and they're standing up. You know, Black Voters Matter, we actually launched what we call the South is Rising Tour, because we could feel it. Those of us that were on the ground could feel the frustration, and that people want something different. People are demanding that democracy is built in this country, that we really actualize it. You know, as she was saying, I think there's some other pieces that we see even in this voter suppression piece. One, around, he's given a tremendous Brian Kemp has given a tremendous amount of discretionary power to these county officials. So you see incidents like what happened in Jefferson County, where people, where you've got officials that are actually abusing their power in circumstances like this. And what even makes it worse is because of the gutting of the Voting Rights Act, where Section 5 was actually struck down, you don't have the preclearance clause that actually provides a mechanism of protection that even in this case would have possibly made someone like this county administrator think before he did such a thing. So I think it's really important what we're seeing across the board, and what we're hearing is that people are really fired up. People are frustrated with what is going on in this country right now, and there are people who are going to fight for democracy, and that as they do that, and as we go to the polls, I think you're going to see record numbers of voter turnout.
LaTosha Brown, thank you very much for the time. My thanks to Katie Phang, who joined me as well. And
thank
sticking
you.
With the midterm elections here, one of the U.S. Senate races we are watching especially closely